Hello everyone, I'm back with one more video of plant anatomy topic. In this topic, we are going to talk about the different types of tissue systems making a complete plant body. There are three types of tissue systems. One is called epidermal tissue system, ground tissue system, and vascular tissue system. Epidermal tissue system is a system where we are going to see the epidermal lining of the plant body, the outermost lining of the plant body, and the different type of appendages arising from this epidermis of the plant. Whereas the innermost of all this is a vascular tissue system, which is making the innermost part of the plant body. So if this is the epidermis, then the centrally located part is called as your vascular tissue system. Vascular tissue system consisting of xylem arrangement and phloem arrangement in the form of different bundles. Whereas any of the tissue which is other than epidermis and the vascular tissue lying in between these two is called as the ground tissue system. So to make a complete plant body, to look to the complete internal anatomical features of the plant body, we will see three types of tissue system arrangement: epidermal tissue system arrangement, outer lining of the body; vascular tissue system arrangement, exactly at the center of the body for the conduction of food as well as water; and in between to this, whatever rest which is remaining, the different cells and the tissues, that will be coming under the category of ground tissue system. So let's begin the first one, that is epidermal tissue system. Now let's talk about epidermal tissue system first. What is epidermis? Everyone knows epidermis is the outermost lining of any plant body. Like in our body also, as an animal body, we have an outermost lining called as epidermal tissue or epidermis of our body, that is called skin. Just in order to protect from any kind of infection, just to protect your internal body parts from the external environment. Similarly, in plants also, there is a lining called as epidermis, which is the outermost layer of primary plant body. Primary plant means initial plant body, which is covered by outermost covering called as epidermis. Epidermis makes boundary between plant and the external environment. So it keeps the internal body parts safe and separated from the external environment by making a boundary between them. If we look to the arrangement of epidermal cells, then each epidermal cell, these are the linings, these are closely arranged parenchymata cells. Remember, epidermis is made up of parenchymata cells, and all isodiametric parenchymata cells are very, very closely attached to each other without any intercellular spaces, making a continuous layer. Very important point, how is the arrangement of epidermis? Epidermis is made up of a thin layer, a layer of many parenchymata cells arranged one next to another without leaving any intercellular spaces between them. Epidermal cells, they have a small amount of protoplasm and a very large central vacuole. So this is a characteristic of the single parenchymata epidermal cells, that they have a very small amount of protoplasm, but their vacuole is quite very large. So cells, they are without intercellular spaces. Cells, they are very largely and tightly bound with each other. Cells, they are arranged in a single layer, making a one complete layer of epidermis. Cells with very less protoplasm, but very big, large central vacuole. In many of the aerial parts of the plant body, the epidermal cells are also showing the deposition of a chemical called as cutin. And definitely, everyone knows the cutin deposit layer is called as cuticle. Cuticle, which is a very important characteristic feature of xerophytic plants or any of the plants which are growing in the dry habitats. Because this cuticle prevents the plant body from the water loss to reduce the excess of transpiration from the plant body. Cuticle sometimes also releases the waxy coating, and this cuticle waxy coating protects the plant from dry conditions. This wax also protects the aquatic plants, the floating plants, from getting wet. So this is the unwettable mucilaginous or waxy coat of the cuticle, which makes them to remain unwet to prevent them from wetting being present in completely aquatic body. Other than cutin deposition in the epidermal lining, some of the grasses, they also show the presence of silica on their epidermal cells. Silica, which provides stiffness and roughness to this epidermis lining. Or maybe they are protecting them from being grazed by the herbivorous animals. So the significance of cutin presence on epidermis is to reduce the rate of transpiration, and silica present on epidermis is to protect them from any grazing animals, providing stiffness and roughness to the grass. It's not a characteristic feature of all, but in few of the grass you can see silica deposits. Now, a very important characteristic feature of epidermal tissue system is the stomatal apparatus. As we know that epidermis lining possess certain openings for the exchange of gases during photosynthesis, as well as to allow little water loss, water evaporation, for the purpose of transpiration. This is a characteristic feature named called as stomatal apparatus, whose major component is the minute pores called stomata or stoma. Stomata, these are the minute openings present in the epidermis meant for the gaseous exchange. These are most abundantly found on the leaves, as well as they are found in the young stems also, but they are most abundantly found on the leaves, nearly 100 to 500 per square millimeter. Each stoma is surrounded by chloroplast containing guard cell. Since class 7th or 8th, we are studying about guard cells, that these are two guard cells which regulate opening and closing of stomata. Now, if we talk about dicot leaf, then we see the shape of the guard cell is a bean shape given in the diagram. But if we look to the monocot leaf, the shape of the guard cell, it is a dumbbell shape. Monocot leaf contains a pair of guard cells which are dumbbell shaped, but if we look to the dicot leaf, the shape is bean shape. Again, if we look to the distribution of the stomata number on monocot and dicot leaf, that is also variable. Like in the monocot leaf, the leaf is called as isobilateral leaf. Isobilateral leaf because the leaf is exactly in a standing position. It's not in a this position, it is always in this position. This is called isobilateral leaf because the stomata is uniformly distributed on both the surface. But when we talk about the dicot leaf, the leaf is a dorsiventral leaf where the distribution of stomata is variable. This is ventral and this is dorsal. Dorsal surface has less number of stomata and ventral surface have more number of stomata. Or if we see about upper epidermis and lower epidermis, if we take the thin section of the leaf, then lower epidermis have more number of stomata in comparison to upper epidermis in order to just to prevent maximum water loss from the stomatal pores. If we talk about the complete stomatal apparatus system, then stomatal apparatus system consists of what of the followings? One opening called as a stoma, regulated by the guard cells. Guard cells contains chloroplast, so these are the green cells. Again, if you look to about the inner wall and the outer wall of the guard cells, they are also variable. Inner wall is thick wall, outer wall is thin wall, and there are attached certain filaments called as microfibrils, which help in the stretching for at the time when the water enters into the guard cells, the guard cells become swollen, lead to the opening of the stomata. So these microfibrils, they actually stretch. So inner wall is stretched and towards the outer wall. So when inner wall is stretched towards the outer wall due to microfibrils, which are the cellulosic fibers, then this get stretched. Guard cells get swollen because of internal movement of the water. When water moves inside to the guard cells swell because of stretching. The inner wall gets stretched towards outwards, lead to the opening of stomata. On the contrary, when guard cell loses the water, these fibrils get relaxed and the inner wall come back to its normal position, lead to the closing of the stomata. So actually stomatal opening is being completely being regulated by the activity of guard cells. Guard cells ki activity of expanding and contracting is actually the ionic movement, especially potassium ion movement from the surrounding subsidiary cells. These are the surrounding subsidiary cells next to the guard cells. Subsidiary cells which are not photosynthetically active cell, yahan par photosynthesis nahi hoti hai, but these are help to maintain the osmotic potential of the guard cells. It is a storage house of the potassium ions. So movement, influx of potassium ions into the guard cells make the guard cells to accept more water and expansion of the guard cell, and efflux of the potassium ions lead to the contraction of the guard cells and lead to the closing of the stomata. This is a Levitt hypothesis. We will see in some another chapter. Yahan par we are just talking about epidermal tissue system, whose one of the very characteristic feature is the stomatal apparatus. So stomatal apparatus of monocot leaf and dicot leaf can be easily differentiated just by looking to the shape of the guard cells. Subsidiary cells are the surrounding ones, and outermost layer of the cell are the normal parenchymatous epidermal cells. So this is very important feature of epidermal tissue system. Along with the cuticle, along with the silica deposits, along with the stomatal apparatus, there are certain epidermal appendages which are coming out from epidermis, like from the root epiblema coming out the root hairs, and the stem epidermis coming out the trichomes. Let's see what are these outgrowths and appendages are. Now next and the last feature of epidermis tissue system is the epidermal outgrowths. Now there are two types of major outgrowths coming out from epidermis lining, one from the stem body, one from the root body. From the stem body, the epidermal growths are called as trichomes, whereas from the root, if it is coming out, they are called as root hair. Trichomes, these are the fine hair which protect young plant organs, or they also help in prevention of maximum water loss from the plant body. They are of different types, can be unicellular and mostly multicellular. They are branched or unbranched, pointed or star shaped. So these are of varying types. Sometimes these trichomes, they are secretory in nature and they secrete nectaries. Nectaries, especially in the insectivorous plants like Venus flytrap, like sundew, that is Drosera plant. There are certain, you must have seen the figure of sundew plant. Go and Google it, see the sundew plant body. Plant body is giving some of the glandular tip containing trichomes from the epidermal lining. These glandular secretions specially contain protein digestive enzyme which help these plants to digest these insects to get energy out of them. If we talk about the roots, then root epiblema or root epidermis, which is also called as piliferous layer, also give rise to some hairy structures, hairy prolongations. But unlike trichomes, these are only and only unicellular in nature. They help in the absorption of water and mineral from the soil. So these all togetherly, these are making the epidermal tissue system component that we have talked about. Epidermis is a completely outermost protective lining, making a boundary between the plant and the external environment. It is a thin layer containing many parenchymatous cells arranged very tightly in close association with no intercellular spaces, and all cells are connected to each other with plasmodesmata connections. Outside to the epidermis, in many of the plants, especially in dry habitat plants, cuticle layer is there, made up of cutin to prevent water loss, sometimes waxy coating for the floating plants to remain or to make them unwettable in the aquatic system. Even in some of the plants, like in grasses, there are the presence of silica deposits to protect them from the grazing animals. Then epidermis has a very important component feature, that is the stomatal apparatus, where the opening is being guarded by the guard cells, variably seen in dicots and monocots. Some of the outgrowths coming out from epidermal tissue called as trichomes and root hair. These are the characteristic feature of the primary plant body. But once primary growth is over and the plant moves towards secondary growth, especially the dicot plants, this epidermis, primary epidermis, get replaced by a very tough and rough cork tissue. Cork, which is the outermost covering, completely made up of dead cells, protected and lined by, covered by a chemical called as suberin. Suberin, which is impervious to water. So when the plant moves towards the secondary growth, at that time, this epidermis get replaced by some of the dead cells, because parenchymatous, these are the live cells. But cork, these are the dead cells where the suberin deposits are there, and this suberin prevents the water loss. Clear? Then if you talk about the remaining part of the epidermal tissue system, let's talk about the function. So function, it is protective. Function, it is making a boundary between the plant from the external environment. It helps in the gaseous exchange. It helps in giving the protection. And sometimes it is secretory in nature, glandular trichomes. Then it is also helpful in the absorption of sap from the soil. So this is all about epidermal tissue system. Hope you would have liked this video. The video was little informative for you regarding one of the tissue system of plant body. In the very next video, we will see vascular tissue system of the plant body. If you like the video, kindly share the video. And if you have not yet subscribed the channel, do subscribe the channel. Thank you so much.